Hi. Thank you for joining us. Thank you, Jordan, for joining us. The question I want to ask you guys is, what's in your pocket? What's the thing that you're probably holding on to right now or touching in some level? It's most likely your phone. And my project is about trying to understand this social and cultural context and the implications of that, right? So what I tried to do was try to create like these sacred moments, as Sherry Turkle calls it, for social engagement in the real world, outside of screens, outside of distractions, outside of mobile. I started out by trying to understand really this kind of what's really happening. And that's an image by a photographer called Eric Pickersgill, which really poignantly explains this, right? Like, we have these intimate relationships with our phones, but what's that really doing to our intimate relationships with other people? Right? So that's really an important thing to understand the question. I wanted to really get into this myself. So I decided to go completely offline. No mobile phones, no internet, no laptop as much as I could do during grad school. And I kept notes. I kept notes of every single moment I wanted to use my phone, why I wanted to use it, how I was feeling at all of this kind of time. I repeated this exercise with five other people and I tried to like, you know, take all this data and try to synthesize like some insight from it. What I found was there are social moments which have been designed for engagement, right? But they've been changed and altered because of mobile phones. So three things that I really pick are dinner or dining between people, when people play games, especially board games, and private spaces, such as the bedroom. So I identify these social moments, but what should I really do? How should I really like intervene in them and change something? And I'm part of the Digital Futures program, so I should be making stuff, which is related to the future and has technology. So this is called persuasive design as a framework of trying to really like alter behavior. It's really cool because it literally breaks down behavior into three really simple things. It's the ability to do a task, it's the motivation of any person to do it, and an adequate trigger. Like, you know, that's a trigger to do something. And when these things kind of intersect at a certain point, habit happens. That's when you actually do an action. So using this as a framework, I designed three objects which tries to basically augment those certain behaviors. I designed a dinner table, which actually can't be used until you actually kept your phones away. It's a kinetic sculpture which continuously keeps moving. You can't keep food on it. You keep your phones away, it comes down, and you can have dinner, and you can eat, you can talk to each other. I'm designing a board game, which is a chess board, which is kind of similar to like Marauder's Map from Harry Potter, which kind of like appears and disappears. So what it'll literally be just a black surface, and then when you keep your phones away, voila, you'll actually see your chessboard. And the third thing is simply an alarm clock, which would go in your bedroom, because that's where an alarm clock would go. But you can only really use the alarm clock when you charge your phone outside of the bedroom.